Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel ECE Scholastic. I am Jasmine Vijitra, working as assistant professor in the department of ECE at RMK College of Engineering and Technology. In the previous tutorial session of control systems, we have seen some basic definitions related to each topic, like what is a control system, what is a transfer function, what is a feed forward and feedback system, and what is a linear time invariant system, right? In today's session, that is under session 4, we are going to see something interesting, that is, what are the mathematical models of control system, what are the elements connected to the model, and what is the force-torque balance equations related to each model for analysis of control systems. Okay, so let's start the session. Let's see the topic one by one in detail. So first is, what is a mathematical model of a control system? So in general, a system is derived with, or a system is defined with some elements. Okay, a system is defined with some elements. So we are going to analyze the system with the help of mathematical expressions, which is called as mathematical models of control systems. Okay. So if the input and the mathematical model is known, then it is possible to determine the value of the output. Okay. So next is the types of mathematical models. So it is broadly classified into two types. One is a mechanical system and the other one is a electrical system. Let's first see what is a mechanical system. In simple words, we can say we are just giving the input to the system in the form of force, torque or motion, and the corresponding output will be determined from the system using the input. Okay. So the mechanical system is broadly classified into two types. One is mechanical translational system and the other one is the mechanical rotational system. So let's see, what is a mechanical translational and rotational system? So if the system deals with linear motion, we can say it is a mechanical translational system. If a system deals with angular motion, then we can say it is a mechanical rotational system. So we can consider a small example, that is movement of bike. Okay, movement of bike is a linear motion. Okay, if the bike is traveling a distance, we can say it is a linear motion. Okay, so the movement of bike is done by the rotation of the wheel. So rotation of the wheel is called as the angular motion. Okay, translational system is a system that deals with linear motion, and rotational system is a system that deals with angular motion. Okay. This is the overall flow of the classification of mathematical models of control systems. So the control system is broadly classified into two types, mechanical system and electrical system. The mechanical system is again classified into two types, translational system and rotational system. Now we are going to see what are the elements connected to the translational system and what are the elements connected to the rotational system. So the elements are mass, is represented as M, spring represented as K, and dashpot represented as B. Similarly, in rotational system, instead of mass, we are having moment of inertia represented as J, and spring represented as K, and dashpot represented as B. So each system has three elements. Similarly, in case of electrical system, we have three elements that are called as the basic elements of electronics, which is resistor R, inductor L and capacitor C. So all these are called as elements of the systems. Okay, elements of classification of systems. Okay. Now let's see an example. See, consider the motion of a tire in a bike. So moment of inertia and mass defines the overall weight of the system. Okay, what is the weight of the system, which is described by the mass and moment of inertia? Okay, now the angular displacement or the angular rotation is represented by angular motion or angular displacement. In all the cars and bikes, you have seen this piston arrangement, right? So the piston is moved with the help of this setup, and the suspension spring is also supporting it, right? So this piston is called as the dashpot, which is responsible for friction, right? The piston is responsible for friction, which is called as dashpot. And the suspension spring is called as the spring, which is responsible for elasticity. Okay, so hope you understood what is mass or moment of inertia and what is dashpot and what is spring. Okay, so mass and moment of inertia is responsible for weight, dashpot is responsible for friction, and spring is responsible for elasticity. So if we consider an object, or a system, okay, whatever elements connected to the system, maybe a number of elements we can say connected to a system. So whatever elements that are connected to the system, each elements will offer an opposing force. Okay. When we are giving an applied force, the system will automatically exert an opposing force because of the elements available in the system. Okay. Now let's see this mass, spring and dashpot in detail. Okay. So for translational system, as we know, we have mass, we have dashpot and we have spring as the elements, correct, for translational system. So mass is used to store kinetic energy, okay, and this dashpot doesn't store any energy and this spring stores potential energy, okay. Now the opposing force, that is when we are giving a force into this mass, the mass itself exerts an opposing force. So we will experience an opposing force due to mass. Similarly, in the case of dashpot, we will experience a force due to friction. Okay. In the case of spring, we will experience an opposing force due to elasticity. Okay. So in the case of mass, force is directly proportional to acceleration. And in the case of dashpot, force is directly proportional to differential displacement. And in the case of spring, force is directly proportional to displacement. Understood? In the case of rotational system, the force is replaced by torque. Okay, in the case of rotational system, force is replaced by torque and mass is replaced by moment of inertia. Acceleration is replaced by angular acceleration. Displacement is replaced by angular displacement. So, rotational system completely talks about the angular motion. Understood? Now let's see the comparison and important points under this translational and rotational system. So here we have some assumptions, that is, in all the system, mass is considered as the nodes. Okay. Mass is the node and it plays an important role. Okay. And all the elements in nature offers us an opposing force. Okay. And also, if there is a mass, see, we are considering a mass. If there is a mass, there must be a displacement. Okay. If there is a mass, there must be a displacement. Okay. So, for analysis of the system, we are using Newton's second law. So, what is Newton's second law? Sum of applied forces is equal to sum of opposing forces. Or in other words, we can say, the total sum of the forces available in the system is equal to zero. Okay. Or in other words, we have one more expression for forces. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay. So, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So, on comparing this mechanical translational system with this mechanical rotational system, the basic elements under mechanical translation is mass, spring and dashpot. Here it is moment of inertia, spring and dashpot. And here, F is called as force, X is called as displacement. So, force is nothing but input to the system. Okay. X is the displacement, which is the output of the system. Similarly, torque is called as the input of the system and theta is called as the angular displacement. So, this is X is linear displacement and theta is angular displacement. Understood? So next we will see the diagrammatic representation of the systems. Okay. So as we know force is the input, X, that is displacement is the output for mechanical translational system. And for mechanical rotational system, torque is the input and angular displacement is the output, right? So this is the diagrammatic representation for mass. So M is mass, F is the applied force. Okay, M is mass and F is the applied force, and X is called as the linear displacement. Okay, X is called as linear displacement. Okay, the next element is, what is this? This is spring. So spring is represented as K, where F is called as the applied force and the X is called as the linear displacement. Next is dashpot. So this is the symbolic representation of dashpot. Here F is called as the applied force, X is called as the linear displacement. So all these comes under mechanical translational system. Okay, next is, this is moment of inertia. J represents moment of inertia. Okay, and T represents applied torque. T is called as applied torque. Okay, and theta is called as the angular displacement. Okay, T is called as the applied torque and theta is called as the angular displacement. So next is, this is torsional spring. Okay, so here also K is spring, T is called as the applied torque and theta is called as the angular displacement. Similarly, this is dashpot. So B is the dashpot, T is applied torque and theta is the angular displacement. So all these three comprises of mechanical rotational system. Understood? Now let's derive the expressions. So as I told you, in mechanical translational system, force is the input, right? Similarly, in mechanical rotational system, torque is the input. As you know, this is mass and this is moment of inertia. Now we are going to derive expression for this. Okay. So we know F is the applied force. And X is called as the linear displacement. Right? So we know all the elements. So whatever elements present in the system. Okay, whatever elements present in the system, it will offer an opposing force. So here we have only one element, mass. So mass itself will offer an opposing force, which is called as Fm. So it's nothing but opposing force offered by mass. Right. So Fm is nothing but opposing force offered by mass. So we have seen that we will be using Newton's second law for analysis. Right. So what is Newton's second law? Newton's second law is equal to sum of applied force. What is applied force? F. So sum of, here we have only one applied force. Okay. So sum of applied force is equal to sum of opposing forces. Right. Sum of opposing forces. So here also we have only one opposing force, Fm. So what is applied force? F is the applied force. And what is the opposing force? Fm is the opposing force. Okay. So by Newton's second law, we know that force is nothing but mass into acceleration. Okay. So what is acceleration? Acceleration is rate of change of velocity. So that is dv by dt. Right. So what is velocity? Rate of change of displacement. So how will you write this? D by dt of what is v? Dx divided by dt. So what is the overall answer? The overall answer is d into dx is d square x divided by dt into dt is dt square. Understood? So here we are going to write opposing force offered by mass. Fm is equal to mass into acceleration is nothing but d square x by dt square. Understood? So similarly, in the case of this moment of inertia, here we know T is called as the applied torque. Correct. T is called as the applied torque and theta is called as the angular displacement. Okay. Theta is called as the angular displacement. Therefore, the moment of inertia will offer a opposing torque Tj, which is called as opposing torque offered by moment of inertia J. Okay. So, similarly by Newton's second law, what we know? By Newton's second law, we know that sum of applied torque, okay, so here sum of applied torque, sum of applied torque is equal to sum of opposing torques. Correct, sum of opposing torque. So here we have only one applied torque, that is T. T is equal to Tj. Correct. So how will you write the expression for Tj? This implies Tj is equal to, how will you write Tj? Instead of M, we will be writing J, and instead of acceleration, here we will be writing d square theta divided by dt square. Understood? Now let's see how we are going to write this expression for dashpot, that is force balance equation and torque equation for dashpot. Okay, so as we know, F is the applied force, correct, and X is the linear displacement, correct. Now by Newton's second law, what we know? Applied force is equal to opposing force, that is F is the applied force. So here dashpot is the element, so FB is the opposing force. So how will you write FB? B into, so dashpot is nothing but, it is related to velocity, correct, it is the motion, right, so it is related to velocity. So we will be writing B into V, so V is nothing but velocity. So, velocity in terms of displacement is, velocity is rate of change of displacement. So, this expression can be rewritten as B into dx divided by dt. So, if we are having two displacements, name it as x1 and x2. So, how will you write Fb? Fb is equal to B into d by dt of x1 minus x2. That is difference of the displacements. Understood? So, similarly, how will you write dashpot expression for applied torque? So, we know T is the applied torque, correct, and theta is the angular displacement. So, by Newton's second law, what we know? By Newton's second law, applied torque is equal to sum of opposing torques. So, T is equal to TB, right, T is equal to TB. So, how will you write TB? TB is equal to B into d theta divided by dt. Okay, B into d theta divided by dt. So, if we have two displacements, theta 1 and theta 2, how will you write TB? TB is equal to B into d by dt of theta 1 minus theta 2. Understood? Now, let's see spring equation. Okay. So, we know K is spring, F is applied force, X is the displacement. So, by Newton's second law, what we know? By Newton's second law, what we know? Applied force is equal to opposing force. So, here spring is the element. So, spring exert an opposing force K. Okay. So, spring is nothing but elasticity. Elasticity means it is expanding, expanding for a particular extent. So, the spring is related to displacement alone. Okay, the spring is related to displacement. So, we will write Fk is equal to K into X, displacement alone. So, if in case we are having two displacements, X1 and X2, how will you write this? Fk is equal to K into X1 minus X2. Okay, similarly for this case, we will write applied torque is equal to opposing torque offered by spring. So, that is Tk is equal to K into, what is the displacement here? Theta. Okay. So, if in case we are having two displacements, how will you write? Tk is equal to K into theta 1 minus theta 2. Understood. So, the overall summary is, mass is related to acceleration, dashpot is related to velocity, and spring is related to displacement. correct? X or theta. Similarly, this is mass or moment of inertia is related to acceleration, and dashpot is related to velocity or angular velocity, and spring is related to displacement or angular displacement. Understood? Next is. So we have seen so far the mathematical model is broadly classified into two types. One is mechanical and the other one is electrical. Okay. So what are the basic components of an electrical network? Resistor, inductor and a capacitor. Right. So for analyzing the mechanical system, we are using force balancing equation as well as torque balancing equation. Right. So for the analysis of an electrical circuit, we will be using mesh analysis or nodal analysis. So mesh analysis is done by Kirchhoff's voltage law and nodal analysis is done by Kirchhoff's current law. Okay. Mesh is nothing but loop. Correct. Node is nothing but junction. Correct. So loop analysis is done by using Kirchhoff's voltage law and this junction or node analysis is done by Kirchhoff's current law. Okay. Now let's see the voltage and current equations for this three basic electrical elements. So for a resistor R, voltage formula is given by Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. So I'm writing this as V of T is equal to I of T into R. Okay. Similarly for inductor, the voltage equation is given as V of T is equal to L into DI divided by DT. Okay. So similarly, for capacitor, we can write the voltage equation as V of T is equal to 1 by C into integral of I dt. Okay. Also, the current equation for the resistor is I of T is equal to, keep I of T in this side and bring this R to that side. So that is V of T divided by R. Similarly, for this, I of T is equal to, keep I here. So the L, when L comes there, it is 1 by L. And d by dt is integral of dt and we have the element V. So, it is V dt. Okay. So, similarly for capacitor, the current equation is I of t is equal to C into dV of t divided by dt. Understood? So far we have seen what is a mathematical model and what are the types of mathematical models. Correct? Also, what are the elements under mechanical, translational and rotational, also the elements under electrical system, also the force balancing and torque balance equations as well as voltage and current equations. Okay. So if you have any doubts under any topics, please let me know. My mail ID is provided in the description box. Please check over it. Thank you. Thank you for your patience. Have a wonderful day.